At the same time, however, he kept a small diary which, in the days when he had found himself, helped in visualizing his tramp life in "The Road." The only out and out juvenile in the Jack London list prior to his death is "The Cruise of the Dazzler," published in 1902. At that, it is a good and authentic maritime study of its kind, and not lacking in honest thrills. "Tales of the Fish Patrol" comes next as a book for boys, but the happenings told therein are perilous enough to interest many an older reader. I am often asked which of his books have made the strongest appeal to youth. The impulse is to answer that it depends upon the particular type of youth. As example, there lies before me a letter from a friend. "Ruth," she is 11, "has been reading every book of your husband's that she can get hold of. She is crazy over the stories. I have bought nearly all of them, but cannot find The Son of the Wolf, Moonface, and Michael, Brother of Jerry. Will you tell me where I can order these? I have not yet learned Ruth's favorites, but I smile to myself at the thought of the rereading she may have to do when her mind has more fully developed." The youth of every country who read Jack London naturally turn to his adventure stories, particularly The Call of the Wild and its companion White Fang, The Sea Wolf, The Cruise of the Snark, and my own journal, The Log of the Snark, and our Hawaii, Smoke Baloo Tales, Adventure, The Mutiny of the Elsinore, as well as Before Adam, The Game, The Abysmal Brute, The Road, Jerry of the Islands, and its sequel, Michael, Brother of Jerry. And because of the last named, the youth of many lands are enrolling in the famous Jack London Club. This was inspired by Dr. Francis H. Bowley, president of the Massachusetts SPCA. The club expects no dues. Membership is automatic through the mere promise to leave any playhouse during an animal performance.